ever known. I could see you there with the city lights, 14th floor, pale blue eyes, I can breathe you in. Two shadows standing by the bedroom door. No, I could not want you more than I did right then. As our heads leaned in, well, I'm not sure what this is gonna be. My eyes closed, all I see is the skyline through the window, the moon above you and the streets below. Hold my breath as you're moving in, taste your lips and feel your skin. When the time comes, baby, don't run, just kiss me slowly. Stay with me tonight, don't leave me alone. She shows me everything she used to know. Picture yeah. frames of country roads when the days were long and the world was small. She stood by as it fell apart, separate rooms and broken hearts. But I won't be the one to let you go.
Thank you. Oh, there's a desert, size can't be measured. I'm gonna count on the fingers. Out there's a world that calls for me, girl. Heading out into the unknown. With fair and strangers and all kinds of danger. Please don't say I'm going alone. Through the ends of the earth, would you follow me? There's a world that was meant for us to see. To the ends of the earth, would you follow me? It's the world I was saved by the nursery. All you do is stand in your place. I'm on a river that winds on forever. Follow till I get where I'm going. Maybe I'm heading to die, but I'm still gonna try. I guess I'm going alone.
welcome family and friends and loved ones. And we're gathered here to celebrate the wedding of Hayley and Jason. And you are here to share in this union and to be witnesses of this great event. And you're here to share their married life as they begin it together. And they're here with the people that are dearest and are loved by them. And on this day of celebration, the bride and groom would like also to take a moment to remember those family members who can be with them solely in spirit. In particular, the bride's father, David Drew, and the groom's father, Norman Kane, whose love and support will be felt by Hayley and Jason always. And they would want you to have a wonderful day filled with all kinds of blessings. Now, to both of you, just a reminder that marriage is perhaps the greatest and most challenging adventure of human relationships. No ceremony can create your marriage. Only you can do that. Through love and patience, through dedication and perseverance, through talking and listening, helping and supporting and believing in each other, through tenderness and laughter, through learning to forgive and learning to appreciate your differences, and by learning to make the important stuff matter and to let go of the rest. What the ceremony today can do is to witness and affirm the choice that you have made to stand together as life mates and partners. And so I put this question to you, Jason. Do you, Jason, take this woman to be your wife?
I do.
And do you, Hayley, take this man to be your husband?
I do.
No couple lives in isolation. We're all here to support them in the vows that they take. And they can be nourished as we support them and encourage them. And in turn, their friends and family can help them and guide them in ways of respect and love. We can provide support for their married life together and this new family that they're creating today. So as a sign of your solidarity and support of them, I invite you to stand. And I put the following question to all of you. Will you who are present here today surround Jason and Hayley in love, offering them the joy of your friendship and your support for them in their marriage? If so, answer, we will.
We will.
Thank you. That was said with great confidence. You may be seated. I'm going to share a reading that has been picked by our couple, and it's a beautiful reading, Robert Fulghum. And he basically helps us to appreciate that all of the planning that we do towards this particular day is part of the process of getting married. He says, "You have known each other from the first glance of your acquaintance to this point of commitment. At some point you decided to marry, and from that moment, that yes, to this moment, which is a yes, indeed you've been making commitments in an informal way. All of those conversations that were held in a car or over a meal or during long walks, all those conversations began with, when we're married, and continued with, I will, and you will, and we will, and all those late night talks that included someday, and somehow, and maybe, and all those promises that are unspoken matters of the heart. All these common things and more are the real process of a wedding. The symbolic vows that you are about to make are a way of saying to one another, you know all those things that we've promised and hoped and dreamed? Well, I meant it all, every word. So look at one another and remember this moment in time. Before this moment, you have been many things to one another. Acquaintances, friends, companions, lovers, dancing partners, even teachers, for you've learned much from each other. But shortly, you're about to say a few words that will take you across a threshold in life. All things between you will never be quite the same. For after today, you shall say to the world, this is my husband, and this is my wife. And so we come to this point in the ceremony where you will be exchanging your vows before God and all of these friends. But before you do, I ask you to remember love. The love you have for one another, a love which is rooted in faith and trust and acceptance. And let this be the foundation of your relationship. No other ties are more tender and no other vows more sacred than the ones that you are about to assume. The vows you take here today are not because of any religious or civic law, but they're out of a true desire to love and be loved by one another fully, completely, and without limitation. And so again, I remind you to always remember your love for one another. And so I'm going to invite you to hold hands and stare lovingly into each other's eyes.
We can do that.
You can do that. And Jason, you can go first. Hayley, today I promise you this.
Hayley, today I promise you this.
I will laugh with you in times of joy.
I will laugh with you in times of joy.
Comfort you in times of sorrow.
Comfort you in times of sorrow.
I will share in your dreams.
I will share in your dreams.
And support you as you strive to achieve your goals.
And support you as you strive to achieve your goals.
Together, let us build a life filled with love.
Together, let us build a life filled with love.
With laughter and learning.
With laughter and learning.
Let us be partners, friends, and lovers.
Let us be partners, friends, and lovers.
Today and all the days that follow.
Today and all the days that follow.
Okay, Hayley, I'll get you to repeat after me. Jason, today I promise you this.
Jason, today I promise you this.
I will laugh with you in times of joy.
I will laugh with you in times of joy.
And comfort you in times of sorrow.
And comfort you in times of sorrow.
I will share in your dreams.
I will share in your dreams.
And support you as you strive to achieve your goals.
And support you as you strive to achieve your goals.
Together, let us build a life filled with love.
Together, let us build a life filled with love.
With laughter and learning.
With laughter and learning.
Let us be partners, friends, and lovers.
Let us be partners, friends, and lovers.
Today and all the days that follow.
Today and all the days that follow.
As a symbol of these vows that have now been exchanged, this couple will exchange rings. And these rings are circles that remind us of God's everlasting love and the permanent love that they share for one another.
You look gorgeous.
Okay, so Jason, you want to take the right ring. I think it's obvious. Put it on Haley's left hand, third finger. And then repeat after me. Hayley, I give you this ring.
Hayley, I give you this ring.
As a daily reminder.
As a daily reminder.
Of my love for you.
Of my love for you.
Okay. You want to take Jason's ring, left hand, third finger. And repeat after me. Jason, I give you this ring.
Jason, I give you this ring.
As a daily reminder.
As a daily reminder.
Of my love for you.
Of my love for you.
Since you, Jason, and you, Hayley, have exchanged these vows with one another and exchanged rings as signs of those promises, it is my great privilege to pronounce you husband and wife in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. And what God has brought together, let no one divide. And you may kiss your bride.
I love you.
And just a final blessing for both of you. Go into the world and fulfill your lives. Hold fast to your ideals. Give to one another new experiences of joy and challenge one another that you may grow. And may the love that you hold for each other, now sealed in marriage, continue to mature, that your life together may be a source of strength and inspiration to the community of your family and to the wider circle of the world. Amen. So we're going to go and sign the register. Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, I have one final favor, and I'm going to ask you to stand. Because I have the pleasure now of introducing to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Jason and Hayley Kane.
Are no longer what's holding you down. secondhand. The way you looked is still vivid to me. You're something out of a dream, messing with my head. And I've been looking for you. Are you hiding? 'Cause I like the way you're calling to me. Wherever she goes, I'm gonna chase. You're something out of a dream, messing with my head.
That which I cherish and that I wrestle, don't want to be like the dust that settles. This empire of nothing, I find that I'm king of all these empty holes, that I'm ruled by my own flaws. But you can't be an old fire if you are burning with a new flame. So remember that you were never a forgotten name. 'Cause I know a land called the land of the living is the world beyond those curtains where we learn to play. I hear the voices of my childhood singing, it's the world beyond those doorways where we used to play. Every moment is a chance to define what you want to become. You're not a slave to the things you've done. Be brave and be bold. Be childish and old. It's the same old story. Every life needs a hope of glory. You can't be an old fire if you are burning with a new flame. So remember that you were never a forgotten name. I know a land called the land of the living is the world beyond those curtains where we learn to play. Oh, we'll go back to the beginning and we'll pick up on the trails of your. Thank you.
So, without further ado, I think it's time to meet the wedding party. First, we have groomsman and brother of the bride, Nick Drew, flanked by the beautiful bridesmaids, Kayla Carson and Jen. And next up, always the life of the party, Miss Jolene Cook and the infamous Mr. Gene W. Porter. And followed by the charming and stunning Christine Linton and Tobias Donat. And our fearless leaders, the maid of honor and best man, Bianca Steeman and Mitch McKay. For only the second time, as husband and wife, Mr. and Mrs. Jason and Haley Kane. So, in terms of the kissing game, the groom and the bride have requested that anybody who wants to suggest a kiss needs to come up here and tell a little story. So I think that's fair game. It'll keep things under control a little bit. So I'm going to get started off. I've got three stories. Sorry.
That instruction for the kissing game.
Is there a different instruction?
Yeah, it's for good marriage advice. There's too many dangerous stories.
Yeah.
You're changing the rules again.
I think it's already been said, but.
Good marriage advice, that's wonderful too.
Good marriage advice is the new direction. Gotta write that one down. So, I'm gonna have to change mine a little bit, but I'll give you some marriage advice. I'll get it kicked off so we kind of all get in the spirit of a little bit of advice for these two. So, let me start off with the first piece of advice. So, as many of you know, Jason and I, along with Mitch, Toby, and Morgan, and a few others here, all went to a boarding school together. And it will likely surprise everyone in the room that despite our rugged good looks and charming personalities, Jason and I were a little late to bloom in the female department. Our combined relationship experience is shockingly rather limited. And no, our school was not boys only, it was fully co-ed. In fact, Hayley, I think, you know, was Jason's real first relationship. Despite some argument, maybe from the groom, and man, did he ever luck out. What made us even more ecstatic is we both found a smart, beautiful, and caring Hayley to marry. Oddly enough, spelt the same way. Just to keep things a little more simple. So Jason, to help give you a head start, I'm willing to lend you my book. It's called Making Marriages Work for Dummies. It's lightly used, and it's a gift for you. I'll hand that to you a little bit later. So here's my second story, a little bit of advice for Haley. So, for years, Jason and I would hit the town Friday and Saturday night. Couldn't be separated. And night after night, we'd go to the bank machine and get cash for the night. Now, Jason had deployed some smart saving tactics, for lack of better words, and one of which was to set a $50 limit on his ATM. Now, back then, most machines only spit out 20, so we're really talking about a $40 limit. And you know, I know some of the old timers might think that's a big bankroll, but in Toronto, it's about two drinks. And Jason, usually has more than two drinks on a given night when we're out in the town. So enter me to pay the tab night after night. And funny enough, even years later, on only their second date, I showed up. I wasn't invited. I'm not quite sure how I ended up on their second date. But somehow, I woke up with the full tab. You're welcome for that. So You know, Hayley is a very strong, smart, and successful business person herself. And I wanted to get you another little gift. Any spare change and money you have around the house, you should probably lock up. Just to put it in safekeeping. So we'll give that one to you as well. You're welcome. And so my final story also happens to be at a wedding. And they're here with us tonight, Teddy and Karen. And what a night. I mean, we danced, we drank, we laughed, we drank and we drank. And, you know, we all decided that it would be easier if we carpooled together back and forth. And the next morning, what we thought would be like an easy 1 hour drive back to Toronto, we had, you know, a set departure time of 9 o'clock. Well, Hayley needed an hour, you know, just to get ready, and it was 10 o'clock. Then it was 11 o'clock. And then I think by about 12 o'clock, we finally got into the car. Well, that was the first part of our journey home. You know, on the way home, I think we had to make 4 or 5 stops along the way. You know, the infamous Harvey's, where both Hayley's took over the bathroom, and Jason and I were waiting out. So, Jason, I think, you know, to save some time in future road trips, I brought you something. Some paper bags. I think it'd just make it a little bit easier. So, in all seriousness, to end with, Hayley is one of the most kind, genuine, and upbeat people that I've ever met. And an added bonus, she laughs at every one of Jason's jokes. And you know, Hayley, I think you did okay too. Jason loves you like none other. I was there from the start, and I could see it with my own eyes. He is fiercely loyal, and from day one, his eyes lit up speaking your name. He treats women in his life like gold. I think Mrs. King can agree and can attest to that. And no, not all sons are like Jason. Cheers to the newlyweds.
Hello, I'm Donna Drew. Very, very happy mother of the bride. I'm happy to be here with all of you today on one of the most joyful days for a parent, sharing a wonderful moment in a child's life. Many of you have known Hayley all of her life, but for those who haven't, I'd like to share some of my memories of raising my girl. Hayley arrived in our family with her lovely red hair and a very strong will to match. As the first grandchild on the Drew side of the family, there were very supportive aunts and uncles, willing to help out with the occasional, okay, frequent, cranky spells. As she grew, Hayley channeled that determination into a love of sports. Hayley started her soccer career as the only girl on her team, a situation that happened again in high school when there weren't enough girls her age to form a team. Being the only girl was not going to stop Hayley from playing a sport she loved. In addition to soccer, Hayley loved figure skating and every team sport that would fit into her schedule. I came to realize that my job as a parent was to ensure that Hayley had a little free time, as she would happily have signed up for everything available. One of the highlights of Hayley's summers, in addition to enjoying the family cottage, was her time spent at Camp Northway. A very rustic camp in Algonquin Park. Sleeping in tents, going on canoe trips, and campfires suited Hayley to a T. It wasn't until years later that I found out that the food was terrible and the supervision a bit lax. Oh well, she survived and had a great time. School was always very important to Hayley. She is the only kid I know who, on being picked up at camp, wanted to know, when does school start? That enthusiasm carried through Hayley's years at Dal, where she had a great time and made some of her closest friends. Hayley then joined Canadian Tire, which brings me to the other important person here today, Jason. I was introduced to Jason at a carefully orchestrated visit. We went to a Tom's Shoes event and decorated shoes before having the first of many fun family dinners. It wasn't long before I realized that I wasn't just getting to know Haley's boyfriend, but the man who would be sharing her life. I think both Hayley and Jason know how happy I am that they have found each other. In Jason, Hayley has a partner who will always support and encourage her, but keep her on her toes. And Jason, you may not have found the most domesticated woman to marry, but you have found one who is fiercely loyal and caring. And where have we heard that term before tonight, both of you? I admire how hardworking you both are, always looking for the next challenge, but managing to balance busy work lives with fun with friends and family. No matter how much you have on your plates, you always arrive at my door wearing big smiles, ready to enjoy family time together. I'm a very lucky mom. I want to wish you both the happiest future together and would ask everyone to join me in a toast to my beautiful girl and her wonderful new husband. Hayley and Jason.
Hello again, everybody. First, I want to thank each and every one of you for coming from near and some of you from very, very far to help us celebrate in this special day for Jason and Hayley. And Donna, thank you for welcoming Jason and I into your family with such warmth. They always say that the secret to a good speech is a good beginning, a good ending, and keeping the part in between as short as possible. So I will endeavor on brevity. Jason, as a little boy, liked movement and speed. He walked early, but he soon discovered that his Fisher-Price truck could get him around the house a lot more quickly. He then progressed to a trike. Then it was the two-wheeler, and the training wheels couldn't come off fast enough. Then there was the mountain bike, because that was a little more adventure. It was the same thing on the hills. He started with us cross-country skiing, but he thought that was a bit boring. So we headed off to the hills and did some downhill, and then he was up for ski racing, because that was more adventurous. He and his dad were avid car racing fans, and fortunately, Jason continued being a spectator and not a racer, much to my relief. In other areas of his life, he could be patient, more reflective, and somewhat slow, his friends might think. A few years ago, well, I thought it was 5 years ago, but it was actually 6 years ago, I learned last night, he started mentioning the name of this lady, Hayley. And it was coming up more and more often, and then she was coming for dinner, family celebrations. Hayley even had the pleasure of going to a Barbra Streisand concert for the first time with us. That's probably her last one. Now, it seems that these people, when they started working at Canadian Tire, said that they were never going to date anybody that was a co-worker. Well, as you can see, that proved to be quite interesting. In April of last year, while they were vacationing in Vietnam on a picturesque island called Halong Bay, Jason proposed to Hayley. She said yes, and here we are today. Their lives are busy. They work, travel, golf, snowboarding, kayaking. But as Donna said, they always make time for family and friends. They just seem to take each step in their life in a stride. For a parent, as many of you know here today, it just seems that the little boy, in the blink of a heartbeat, turns into a young man. And your dad would be really proud of the man that you've turned out to be today. You're now both moving into a new chapter of your lives. And the person that you love is very special, and I'm delighted to have Hayley as a part of our family. I feel like I've gained a daughter, not a daughter-in-law. As you go down this path together, I wish you love, happiness, and friendship. I'm sure a lot of couples here will have all kinds of advice to give you about marriage. Remember that marriage is like a garden. It really takes time to grow. But the harvest is rich for those who patiently and tenderly care for the ground. And now I hope that each of you here will have a great time tonight. Thank you.
Different pieces of advice. This one's very specific to Mr. Jason Kane. We have some custom pink earplugs. For those of you who don't know Kaner, he's a loud sleeper like myself. So I think, Hayley, these may come in handy, you know, especially maybe even tonight. So there you go. I think you owe us a kiss.
Our advice is don't have more than 3 kids. Have as many as you want, but not more than 3.
Not more than 3.
All right? Thank you.
All right, so good evening, everybody. My name's Jonathan. My lovely wife, Erin, is a cousin of the groom tonight, and I don't have any great marriage advice, but I do have a funny story that I'd like to tell. So we're going to go back to university. We're going to go back to Queen's University about 15 years ago. I was a second year student looking for an easy course, so I took Introduction to World Religions 200. Pretty easy course, cruised through with 75. My girlfriend at the time, now my wife, the next year comes along, who was a year behind me at Queen's, and says, I'm looking for an easy course, take World Religions 200. I've got all the answers, I've got all the essays. Sure enough, the prof gives the first assignment, the exact same question as the year before. My wife prints a new cover page, puts her name on it, submits it. Does it for the whole year, comes out with like an 80. 2 years later, her cousin, Jason, comes along looking for an easy course. She's like, we got this course, World Religions, we got all the answers. First assignment comes out. Sure enough, Jason just changes the cover page, puts his name on it, hands it in. Next week, professor says, Mr. Kane, I'd like to talk to you. Mr. Kane comes into the office. The professor says, great answer to the essay. But that wasn't the question. That was the question from last year. So if you like a chance at doing that again, you're going to have to submit it in. So congratulations, guys. If there are any Canadian Tire executives in the room, just pretend you didn't hear that. Congratulations.
Everybody. I'm Bianca. I'm a close friend of Haley's from high school. I'm also an ex-neighbor and an honorary Drew family member. So Haley and I met on the very first day of grade 9. Okay, so picture this. This sweet bride, our sweet bride right there, waiting for her bus with headphones on, blaring Eminem at 7:30 in the morning. That was my first impression of Haley. I didn't know if she was like Aurelia's next best rap superstar or like trying to assert dominance over the bus stop, but it worked. I was terrified. It wasn't too long before you took those headphones off, and then we quickly became the best of friends. From the weekly Gilmore Girls episode with Donna and Nick, to being members of our beloved adventure gang, to our more mature days of talking about our futures while we're drinking warm, syrupy, stolen Woody's coolers. Yeah. To this day, where I am so proud to stand beside you on your wedding day. And wow, what a day it's been. Haley, Jason, you guys did excellent work. And let's not forget the hard work of these mamas So everybody, a round of applause for these guys. So Hayley has many incredible qualities that I could probably go on and on and on and on and on about, like her drive to become this kick-ass businesswoman, her dedication to her family, or her extreme athleticism. This girl can do the pretzel in figure skates. It's crazy. But the thing I'd like to focus on tonight is her laugh. You have all heard it. This girl laughs at everything. It's the best. Hayley's laugh, it highlights her amazing traits of being a great listener, being super supportive, and having a great sense of humor, all in one crazed giggle on steroids. Does anyone else feel like the funniest person in the world when they hang out with Hayley? Jason, good, yes. Right, and this is where Jason comes in. You're like actually funny. Does she ever stop laughing when you're together? It warms my heart to see you two laughing your way through life side by side. I mean, Jason, I think Hayley couldn't even keep it together for your entire proposal. Laughter. She was laughing the whole time. I saw the video. Whether it's bedazzling your shoes together or being the funniest aunt and uncle to Aubrey, you two are made for each other. Hayley, you are the best friend I ever could have asked for. You love unconditionally, and you always make me feel like I'm the best person I can be when I'm around you. That's just who you are. I am so happy that you have found Jason, your perfect partner who will keep you laughing, who encourages your dreams, and who you will share all of life's adventures with. Your person that makes you be the best that you are. So now, who is ready to celebrate this beautiful couple on this unforgettable day? A toast to Hayley and Jason.
Okay, Jason King wedding speech. Okay, I got the right piece of paper here. That's always a good start. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, Jason and Hayley, for inviting me to be your best man. I've never been invited to do this before, so really excited about it. And hopefully it goes okay. Okay, so I looked up on the internet how to do a speech because, of course, I've never been a best man before. So they said, like, you gotta start with like a warm up joke or, you know, some sort of thing to get the crowd to like you. So I'll skip that part and I'll just go right to a story. So, a gentleman of good taste, rigor, and upstanding morals, and his then girlfriend invited his equally upstanding friend and wife to their cottage rental on an extremely upscale, highly exclusive farm creek in the borderlands of the very well-to-do Canadian Shield region of Ontario. A very expensive array of meats and cheeses, bourbon, fine American beer, delicious fruits, vegetables were on hand for a fantastic few days of light conversation and a competition featuring various feats of strength. Now, although the cottage was built to impeccable standards and maintained a very low carbon footprint, the walls were simply just a symbol of a barrier. It is worth noting that the upstanding friend and wife were given an abode with some passionate after effects and echoing enchantment. One night, probably after some light snacks, gentle conversation, and a soft game of cards, both the couples retired behind their paper-thin walls. Much noise was made that night. Most of it incomprehensible, perhaps some of it competitive. Anyways, 9 months later, a baby was born. That may one day swim upstream to return to that exclusive farm creek on the edge of the Ontario-Canadian Shield. And I may happen to know the name of that baby. And some may look at that as a final win in the feats of strength competition conducted at the fine cottage some 5 years ago. Hello, I'm Mitch McKay. I'm the best man. I'm aware it is an extreme cliche to say it's an honor to stand up here. Everyone says it, but I guess I'd like to just unpack it a bit. I look at the lovely maids of honor and the bride, and I see unwavering radiance, kindness, and the bride is a fortress of gorgeousness. And I look at the gentleman. Well, Kate's hair's nice. You have nice hair, Kate. It's very nice. You did it up nice today. It looks good. I've known Jason for, going on 24 years. We attended Trinity College School together, and for some reason, we've lasted as friends, right through till now. But we'll see what he thinks after this speech. It has been a pleasure to get to know everyone in the wedding party, and also both families. You have truly raised some exceptional human beings. A special side note on exceptionally good taste and intelligence of Kayla. A few years back, she made a very common mistake. She mistook me for a finely tuned professional athlete. And although I was not at the time a professional athlete, if it were not for perhaps some poor coaching and bad advice from my father, amongst other maybe bad decisions, things could have been different. Although, as the wedding party can attest to, when I dusted off, my natural athleticism is still strong, witnessed on the golf course today, right? Like, that was pretty impressive. I can't really remember the first time I met Jason. Perhaps it was on the sports pitch where I was impressed with his immense dexterity and physical acumen. Maybe it was in the classroom where I was awestruck with his vast intelligence and oral superiority. A real Renaissance man of the ninth grade. In reality, we probably joined together through a mutual awkwardness with girls, a love for literary greats like Hunter S. Thompson and Dungeons and Dragons books. Sounds exciting, doesn't it? Probably the underlying reason is because he was the only one that would come to dinner with me at our boarding school, so we didn't have to sit alone. After high school, we departed in opposite geographic directions of higher learning. I would hear from a distance how things were progressing with my friend. He had become a sandwich artist. This. This now impresses my daughters immensely. There's no other accomplishment that ranks with sandwich artists. We would we would meet up and, you know, go to concerts with his new friend Porter. Nine Inch Nails, Tool, Smashing Pumpkins, deep introspective affairs where the meaning of life was contemplated and solutions to wide-ranging matters of metaphysics were worked out. But unfortunately, we didn't have any notepaper to jot them down. It was when we had both moved back to Toronto, where my incredible savviness with the opposite sex would be able to assist Jason on a full-time basis in finding a suitable partner. No doubt, Rob and Toby were also helpful in this arena, as they too were very well skilled. I remember the first time Jason told me about Hayley. He had met this beautiful red-headed vixen at work. To date, she had largely ignored his passes. He was looking for reassurance to continue his pursuit. I think we tried to clarify how beautiful before pushing any further advice. In the end, after much discussion and libation, it was decided that a blind squirrel eventually finds a nut. I eventually met Hayley. She was indeed beautiful, kind, a great sense of humor, and had a natural, gentle kindness, just like my friend. A relationship born at the holy grail of Canadian retail patriotism. Decorated with visions of motor master innovations and mastercraft sales forecasting. I have no idea why it took Jason so long to marry her. Perhaps he was searching for a good deal on the correct ring. Okay, now for the serious part of the speech. My daughters, who are all below 8 years old, constantly talk about their best friends. They switch with some regularity, as little kids do. They always have a new best friend. And they're just learning to communicate effectively. Good friends that last are those you have the uncanny ability to communicate and learn to communicate with on just about anything with very little judgment. Jason has been this friend for me. This isn't just the love between friends. This is also what I believe sustains love in my marriage. We communicate, we try not to judge, and at points, we both sacrifice. Measuring the sacrifice can be contentious. I'm no expert, but who really it is? I see this between Jason and Hayley. They love each other, they communicate exceptionally well. I heard it through the paper-thin walls of the cottage some 5 years ago. Thank you very much.
The atmosphere, keep me warm inside our bed. I got dreams of you all through my head. Fortune teller said I'd be free, and that's the day you came to me.
Love you more, so don't be scared when we're older. told me there'd be days like this. Well, you don't need to worry. There'll be days like this. Well, no one's in a hurry. There'll be days like this. Well, you don't get betrayed by that old Judas Christ.
Should we start by giving ourselves some marriage advice so I can kiss you?
Yes!
Yeah. Let me think. This is important. Marriage advice. Always listen to Hayley.
There we go. That'll do.
After you.
Always obey her.
Obey.
Right. You obey. Yeah.
There's more advice coming here. This is troublesome.
Good evening, everyone. Today has been everything that Jason and I could possibly have hoped for, or I suppose my husband and I could possibly have hoped for.
I have a wife.
All of our most cherished people all in one room to help us celebrate today. Although as we were preparing for this speech, we realized not everyone may know the way in which we came to be a couple.
Although some of them heard a little bit earlier tonight.
Yes.
Yeah. So we thought we'd share each of our perspectives on what that wonderful moment was like. So I vividly, very vividly remember the first time I talked to Hayley, and I had seen her for quite some time, and it was at a work event at Canadian Tire, and I was so excited. I went over, started to chat with her, and I thought it was great. This woman is beautiful. She's smart, she's really interesting, and she's laughing at all of my jokes. That day I felt great. I was like, this is wonderful, but there was a bit of bad news. I never got a date that day. And you know, I was disappointed, but little did I realize at the time that Hayley laughs at pretty much everyone's jokes. And so it wasn't so much my fault, it was just, you know, we were just adjusting there. But despite my best efforts, you know, it ended up not being a date. But you know what I'll tell you here today? Persistence is important. So it took 9 months for her to overcome my first impression. But it was worth every day, and you know, needless to say, it's obviously worked out very well. So
I remember it a bit differently. So the first time Jason and I spent time together was at a trade show at work. I was working in the Christmas business at the time, and we were running a little behind. So Jason and Linda, actually down here, offered to help decorate a Christmas tree with me. I used the term help pretty loosely. There were many broken ornaments. The tree was on its side before we were done, but he kept me laughing the whole time. This is a theme tonight, but I assure you, it was all genuine. There were no pity laughs from me that evening. I was caught off guard, admittedly, when I realized he was flirting with me.
Who wouldn't be?
In my mindset, I couldn't possibly date a coworker. Obviously, over time, I put that aside, and I can assure you, by the time that first date came around 9 months later, I was the one flirting with him.
And as Payne mentioned earlier tonight, he was very kind, and he financed, I don't know if it was our second or third date.
I think it was our second, yeah.
But to be fair, he wasn't invited. He just was there, and so I figured that was a fair trade.
So we wouldn't have made it here today without everybody in this room. You've all impacted us in an enormous way. I want to start by specifically calling out a few people. Mom, thank you isn't adequate to describe how lucky I am to have you as my mom. Your strength and determination has taught me to be brave and go after my dreams. Your love for travel has given me a sense of adventure, and I got a smidge of your artistic ability, which was put on grand display tonight. My mom sewed all of the napkins this evening, so thank you so much for that, Mom. For these and so many other things, I thank you from the bottom of my heart. I love you so much. On to my bridesmaids, Christine, Jolene, Jen, and Kayla. We met in our first few years at Dalhousie University in Halifax, Nova Scotia. We left with degrees in business and beer and a lifetime bond. Thank you all so much for this year of events planning, in particular the DIY projects I subjected you to. These group of women are so talented and so wonderful in so many ways, but crafting is not one of their skill sets. Thank you, ladies. And finally, my maid of honor, Bianca. B, we're coming up on 16 years of friendship. It's pretty wild. We grew up together, we went to school together, we played sports together, and we even worked together. Your parents, Tina and Casey, are here tonight, gave me my first job in retail. We've lived 2 minutes apart, we've lived continents apart, and no matter the distance or the time, whenever we're together, it's as if no time has passed at all. Thank you for all of your support over the years, in particular this past year, especially with the brass candlestick hunt of 2018. You were instrumental in ensuring we had candlelight this evening. Thank you. You mean the world to me. I love you.
So I also want to start. I have a couple thank yous to share tonight. So first off, to the wonderful lady that I just shared a beautiful dance with, my mother. Thank you so much for all of your love, advice and really patience with me over the years. I know I've been a handful at times, but I like to think that we smiled along the way, and I've learned so much, and I appreciate so much about how you've raised me. It's obviously worked out well for me. Whereas, I want to be clear on that. You know, they say marrying up is the best thing you can do in life, right? So chalk one up. I'm truly I'm so thankful and very lucky to have you as a mother. So thank you, Mom. I love you so much. The groomsmen. What? I'm not even going to look at the notes there. That's a cast of characters over here. Look at these guys. They clean up pretty nice, though, I have to say. Like, you throw on a couple suits, they're looking good. But these are guys that I've had the pleasure of knowing, some from high school, some from university, and you know, I'll be the first to say, you know, they're not the smartest guys here. You know, they're not the most handsome guys here, but they are my brothers, And I am so thankful to have you for that, and I really appreciate all the friendship, and couldn't be happier to have you stand up with me today. So thank you, boys. To Mitch, who apparently should go into speech writing and performance art, like that. It was fantastic. You had me laughing out of my chair. I think everyone learned a lot about architecture and the importance of construction. But what a great speech tonight, Mitch. So thank you so much tonight. It's hard to believe. I think it's actually been close to 25 years that we've known each other. We're dating ourselves a little bit here, but it's been an amazing friendship, and there's so many wonderful and embarrassing moments over the years. So I really appreciated. I remember I was thinking of the different stories to tell, and you referenced a great point. You know, I thought I'd talk about a little bit of us growing up, and the first story I was going to share was about playing Dungeons and Dragons in the basement. And you know, that was when we weren't so popular with the ladies, but we grew, you know, and we developed a little bit later on. You know, we went on rugby tour, maybe did a little bit better socializing in the world. But what I'd say is amazing. It's really great to see you now as a husband and a father of three feisty and fiery little girls who are wonderful and a great wife. So I'm so happy to see you as a family man, and I wish you the best with their teenage years. It's going to be really, really fun to watch. But you're truly have always been an amazing friend, and thank you so much for everything tonight and everything you've done over the years. So to everyone here, you know, Hayley and I were chatting yesterday, and in the afternoon before people started to show up, you know, it didn't feel like the wedding had started yet. And then we were in the lobby and guests started to stream in. And what I would say is thanks to all of you coming here tonight and sharing this time with us really makes this moment special. It's because of you that our lives are the way they are. We appreciate everything you bring to us, contribute to us, and that all the times we shared with you. So thank you so much. I know people have traveled, whether it's from England, from northern Manitoba, from the US, you know, from everywhere across Ontario. So we really do appreciate everyone coming here today and spending this time with us. So thank you very much for that. And then last but not least, to my beautiful bride here, Hayley. I have, actually my wife, I still have to adjust to that. And bride. You don't know how happy you make me every day. Your laugh is real and I believe it now. And at least most of the time. And you always put a smile on my face. I love you so much, and I couldn't be happier to be your husband. All right. So I believe I now have the distinct pleasure this evening to introduce Mrs. Hayley Drew and Mr. Jason Kane for their first dance as husband and wife. Thank you.
Walking through the mountains, I wandered through the trees for her. I have been trying to find her, wanna give what I've got. She lit a fire and now she's in my every look.
She lit a fire and now she's in my